Hello everyone, how is everyone doing? Very good. Thank you for the kind introduction, Principal Madam. Respected Academic Committee Chair, Sri Krishna Dev Rao Garu, Chairman, Sri Murli Mukund Garu, and Principal Varalakshmi Garu, and Academic Director Sri Devi Garu, and respected dignitaries, Dr. Rakesh Sahai and Dr. Naunihal Singh, Dr. Janaki Srinath, Dr. KMK Reddy, and my brother Dr. B. Prabhakar, and Varewa Chef Mr. Sanjay Tuma, and all the students, parents, and everyone else. It's a great honor, pleasure, and privilege for me to be present here today for this childhood obesity program, which is a pilot program in this very prestigious school. By the way, today's morning walk, did you all enjoy it? Very good, very good. For me, it was really exhilarating walking with you all. For me, though I have done similar walks, almost like 70 back there in US, for me this is very, very special. And I'm going to cherish this memory because I'm doing it for the first time in our motherland, India, especially in this very prestigious, vibrant, and dynamic Jubilee Hills Public School. I'm also happy because my mother and family are in the audience. I think I'll start the slideshow. We like to call this like a no-obesity revolution. There's no such word like no-obesity in the dictionary. We just coined this. And why do we have this initiative to fight childhood obesity? Right now, this has become a global epidemic. When I say global, it means it's affecting almost all the countries in the world. India, as of now, it is catching up with the other developed countries like US, China, Japan, South Korea, and we want to catch this epidemic at an early stage in our country. The next generation is expected to have a shorter lifespan than the current one if this epidemic continues. Basically, this picture shows a boy who is like normal weight, then progresses to overweight and then obesity. Now, what is childhood overweight and obesity? For children and adolescents between the ages of 2 and 19 of the same age and sex, overweight is defined as a body mass index at or above the 85th percentile and lower than the 95th. Whereas obesity is defined as BMI above the 95th percentile. Now, this is a very busy slide. It's a BMI chart. Basically, the one which is green, it shows the normal weight. The yellow is above 85th and the red is above 90th percentile. But this graph is very important. The top line, it shows the US. In US, almost one third of the children are obese, like one in three. Whereas if you come to the very bottom, that is India, it is anywhere from about 2% in girls and a little bit higher, like 5% in boys. I don't know why the difference, but that's how it showed in the Lancet May 2014 study. Now, being overweight or obese is like carrying a load on your back. Who wants to carry a load on their back? No one, you know? This slide is going to come up in a few seconds. Obesity affects almost all the organs in the body. It causes high blood pressure, diabetes, high cholesterol, which in turn causes heart attacks, strokes, and early death. It also affects, like, if you take the GI system, it can cause liver problems, gallstones, acid reflux, pulmonary problems, then kidney problems. It also causes cancer. Very few people know that obesity can cause cancers. I think that slide is not okay. Basically, this tells about all the organs that are affected by obesity. Now, what can we do to fight this childhood obesity epidemic? The World Health Organization, they have recognized that prevention is the most feasible option for curbing this childhood obesity epidemic. To do this, we need to educate the children, the parents, the schools, communities, everybody, by helping to make the healthy choice an easy choice. So that's what the World Health Organization has come up with. And to prevent, we need to educate. So that's where our role comes in. Now, to do this, what we did, we made this logo so we can educate and empower everybody to take care of themselves. I think the logo is over there on the stage at the back. At the bottom, you see that it says educate and empower. And I noticed that the Jubilee Hills Public School, the logo, which is on the top, you can see that there's the sun and the book, and it says like Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, which is basically taking you from darkness to light, which is basically to educate you all. So I see the similarity between the logo, and it has made me happy. If you see the slide, there's a number 12, 12, 12. That is when we started this campaign of childhood obesity awareness. We started it on December 12, 2012. Actually, we inaugurated it by balloon release at 12 seconds past 12 minutes past 12 noon on 12, 12, 12. That's when we started. And on the logo, you see a man, a woman, and a child. Basically, what it means is the whole family should be involved in fighting this problem. Everybody's involved. It's not just the parents, not just the kid, but it's a family effort. And then it also shows that the people are walking on the track. That is to show you all that brisk walking is one of the easiest and the best ways to exercise. That's the other reason we put that. And then the rainbow colors around the logo, that actually indicates like unity in diversity. It's to show that obesity can affect anybody of any color, race. And it also indicates that when you eat like rainbow colored fruits and vegetables, you get a lot of nutrients. So that's how we made the logo. So the logo basically has a lot of information in it, if you understand what each one stands for. And the very center of the logo is yellow color. That's how you see. What color are you all wearing today? Yes, that's what is in the center of the logo. And we are trying to promote wear yellow for healthy lifestyles and obesity awareness. Just like how we use red for heart disease, pink for breast cancer, blue for colon cancer. So in a similar way, we are trying to promote yellow color. Nelson Mandela, he's one of the Nobel Peace Prize winners. He said, education is the most powerful weapon we can use to change the world. So that's where our role comes in. We want to educate everybody. Now, the father of surgery, who is Sushruta, long back, 600 years BC, at that time itself, he discovered that obese people who are sedentary develop diabetes, and he advised physical exercise to treat diabetes. So this problem was recognized like thousands of years ago. And the father of medicine, Hippocrates, about 140 years later, in 460 BC, he said, if we could give every individual the right amount of nourishment and exercise, not too little and not too much, then we would have found the safest way to health. Actually, in India, we have a dual problem. We have malnutrition and overnutrition, which is obesity. So we have to work on that. Okay, this is the main thing which I want all the kids to learn. We are trying to promote this 5-2-1-0 concept. If you look at the back of the t-shirt, what does it say? 5-2-1-0, magic. It's like magic for the kids. If you follow this 5-2-1-0 rule, this was developed by three big organizations: the American Medical Association, the CDC, which is Centers for Disease Control, and the Maternal and Child Health Bureau. Now, five stands for, can you read what's on the Very good. Every day you try to eat about 5 fruits and vegetables. Fruits and vegetables together 5. And 2 stands for, can you read? What's on? Very good. What it means is you don't want to watch too much TV, too much video games, all those games that you play. You don't want to spend too much time on that. You do not want to spend more than 2 hours. The less, the better. And the 1 stands for? Yes. What did you do today morning? You did vigorous activity. You were walking fast. You were walking briskly. So that is exercise. Okay? So 1 stands for 1 hour of vigorous activity. And the 0 stands for, which is like Coke, Pepsi, processed like fruit juices and all those. Let me see. Now, this is the same thing in different words. You want to drink more of water and low-fat milk rather than the soft drinks like Coke, Pepsi and some of the bottled juices. Okay, the other thing which I want you to remember is your plate. When you serve food on your plate, make sure that half your plate is made up of fruits and yes. And then 1/4 of the plate, you can put your like grains, which could be like chapati or rice. And then the other quarter, you want it to be like protein. And the cup on the right side, it indicates you can drink a lot of milk. Milk or water is better than the sugary beverages. So choose my plate. Easy way to remember is you have your plate should be fruits and vegetables. Okay, this one basically tells you you want to eat a variety of fruits and vegetables, different colors, like rainbow colors. That way you get a lot of vitamins, minerals, micronutrients. So that was the reason we put the rainbow colors around the logo. And then when I say eat colorful, it doesn't mean you eat like colorful candy, right? Because those colors are not natural. So you don't be tricked. You don't say, oh yes, I was eating colorful foods, which is like candy. No, you want to eat like naturally colorful fruits and vegetables. And good foods are usually very colorful, whereas bad foods are usually like brownish. Like you see here, what are they? French fries. Do you all eat French fries? Yes. Well, you can eat, but not too much. You want to eat very, very little because they're not really healthy. Okay? Again, don't be tricked. The nuts are brown in color, but they're naturally brown and they're very healthy. So remember that the nuts, though they are brown, they are like very healthy. And then you want to avoid too much of oily and greasy foods. Now talking about activity, vigorous activity means anything like, it could be like walking, running, jogging. You can do like jump rope or any kind of sports, even housework, gardening, all that is a vigorous activity and it counts as exercise. And you don't want to spend too much time watching TV and video games. Okay. Okay. These are pictures from some of the school events. We asked a little girl to show some vigorous activity and then this is what she did. She did some somersaults and then some kids were doing hula hoops, playing ball, jumping. All this would count as exercise. 1 small can of soda has how many teaspoons of sugar? Okay. So that's a lot. That's like 5 times what your like parents have in their tea. Like let's say they have 2 teaspoons of sugar in tea. Imagine putting 10 teaspoons of sugar in a cup of tea. Would it be sweet? Very sweet. But that's how much sugar is there in 1 can of soda. So in other words, sodas are not good at all. That's why in 5210, we say zero amount of sugary beverages. Posted over here, which says be healthy and be happy. That's what I heard a lot of kids saying today while doing the walk. I really liked it. Be healthy and be happy. Now, do you like the picture of all the children jumping in the air? Yes. That picture, it got the first prize in the national photo competition, Intel photo competition. These are chips, chips and French fries. Are they healthy? Very good. You got the point. And what color are they? Very good. Okay. These again are very tasty. They are snacks. You can eat them, but you want to eat very small quantity. Okay. You can see these samosas, pakodas and bhajis and all that. So what color are they? Very good. Okay, this is what Dr. Aditya Vikram showed you all. So one small can of soda has how many teaspoons of sugar? About 10. Each cube there represents a teaspoon of sugar. Okay, people think, okay, I'm not going to have sodas. I'm going to have fruit juices. But remember, bottled or bottled fruit juices also have a lot of sugar in them. So remember that. Fresh fruit juices are better than? Yes. I mean, you can have them, but not too much. They're just like sometimes food, you know, not every time food. All right. So basically, this is where we started. We want to educate the students, the parents, schools, communities, states, and as many countries as possible. Do you like today's event? Are you enjoying it? Very good. So this is what we want to do in as many schools as possible. And I want you all to go home and tell your parents what you learned. Will you do that? Very good. All right. The reason we are doing this walkathon events is because it's fun. When you have fun and you're learning, you tend to remember better. So that's how we came up with these walkathon events. All right. This talks about why we are wearing yellow today. So yellow, just like the sun, in your school logo. Do you like your logo? I really love it. Do you like the logo? Yes. What do you see on there? Sun? Yes. What color is it? Just like your t-shirts. Now yellow, it stands for energy, motivation. Very good. Very good. So you got that. And today morning, you're always singing, be healthy and be happy. Ultimately, that's what we all want, right? You want to be happy and you want to be healthy. All right. And this again is the same thing. Okay. This is what we thought. For childhood obesity, we are going to use the tagline of be fit and be. How many of you all like to be cool? Raise your hands. Very good. So for childhood obesity, this is the tagline we are using. Be fit and be cool. But as for adult obesity, okay, by the way, we do these events not just in schools, but also we do non-school events. We also go to like bigger organizations, conferences, and we try to do a similar thing for the adults too. And there we use the tagline of be healthy and be happy. It basically amounts to the same thing. Now, these are some of the pictures from previous events. This is at the Global Association of Physicians of Indian Origin. This was in Chandigarh, Punjab. We did this recently, actually, in January of this year. Now, this was the first pilot program in USA. Now, the program today in your school is the pilot program we are doing in India. Do you feel proud about that? Very good. Very good. So this picture is from the pilot program in USA, just like how we are doing here today. And that was in April 2013, 2 years ago. So far, we have done similar events in 71 schools as of June 2015. Now here you see a dietitian. She is doing a show and tell program for the school children. She's showing them good foods and bad foods. She has models over there on the table. Now, this is just like how we did today morning. Does it look something like how you all did? Yeah. But yours was a very, very big group. I think you are 600 students. Did you know that? 600. That's a big number. So yours was very, very good. I think yours was a much, much, much bigger program than the pilot program we did in USA. So big up. Want to clap for that. Very good. Okay. This is the classroom where one of the doctors is talking to the kids, like just like how we are talking right now. These are some nice pictures from the previous school events in US. Okay. This is when we started, 12-12-12. Okay. By the lady over there, she is the governor of Oklahoma, who made an official proclamation to wear yellow for childhood obesity awareness. So, I'm going to request the school committee maybe try to get a similar proclamation, maybe from the Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji. That's what we should try. Would it be nice? Yes, and yours will be the pilot school program trying to do this. I put this picture here because this is Dr. Vivek Murthy. He's the first Indian to be the US Surgeon General. That's the highest medical post in USA. You know, I think hands off for him. This doctor, he had come recently for a childhood obesity event just like this, and he talked about childhood obesity. So we have a lot of big shots trying to help us do this in US. Now, this lady, she's very, very pretty. She is Miss Nina Davuluri, and she was the first Indian to be Miss America. But, yeah. And what shirt is she wearing? What kind of shirt is she wearing? Yellow. Same shirt that you are wearing now. And it so happened that she was wearing the same yellow when she won the crown. So that was really a nice coincidence. So even she has been, actually, can you believe that when she was young, she had this childhood obesity problem, but she worked on it, she lost her weight, she got this healthy weight, and then she became Miss America. So big hands off for that. So it's very easy to tackle this problem if you have this problem. Okay? So all you have to do is basically eat healthy, exercise, and follow the 5-2-1-0 magic. Okay. This is my dad. He's my father, Dr. B. Ramlingam, professor of medicine. He is the one who has inspired me to do what I'm doing. He would always be doing community service and advising people about their health. And he would always be telling that an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. So I put this picture because, you know, he's been my inspiration all along. And also I thank my mom for coming here. She's in the audience. She wanted to know what I do in States. So I said, well, come on over today and see what I do. So that's how she's here. So thank you very much. Did you all enjoy this? Very good. So you're going to remember 5-2-1-0 magic. 5 stands for? Very good. 2 stands for? Very, yes. And 1 stands for? All right. And 0? Very good, very good. Thank you all. I really enjoyed it.